We're going to show how to install and get started with Fluke DPC Track 2 software. I've already installed the CD with Auto Run, and I have the installation and menu available on the screen. I will initiate the installation by clicking on Install DPC Track 2 software. Installation continues. It's preparing to install. DPC Track 2 software will evaluate and determine if there's adequate room to install the application. So the install shield is prepared and ready. So next to install, I will click Next. Confirm the end user license agreement by accepting. Then select Next. Confirm the information in the README file. Note that this is a trial expiration and it will expire to a load/unload utility after 60 days. Next, confirms your installation and the user. Update with your actual username and select Next. Next, identify the location you want the files to be installed. If you want to install to a different drive other than C drive, select Change and select the drive that you want to install them in. Now it will install to D drive, then select Next. Next, you will be prompted to identify the location to install the data directory of the database. Next, select Standard or customize the application installation. Typical users will select Standard and then select Next. Here you will see the installation information, where the application will be installed, the name and the company name. If you're satisfied with that information, select Install. The status bar will tell you the progress as the installation occurs. Here we are with the installation complete. By selecting Finish, DPC Track 2 will auto-launch. Select Start Trial to initiate your 60 days with the trial software. Then select Next. Input the name that you would like on your reports. Logging in for the first time. The default login is admin for user ID and admin for password. Password is expired. You are required to enter a new password on first login. Type in your password once and then a second time to confirm. In the opening screen, you can view reminders. Right now there are no reminders of overdue devices. We can look in and see late devices and calibrations. We can also open the DPC Track Explorer, which is the easiest way to navigate the product. In DPC Explorer, you can see instruments, test instruments, and cals due within 45 days. To open up and look at an instrument, double-click on the device, and it'll open up for review. You can see this is an example TC transmitter. This is one of the example tags that are shipped with a product that can be modified and cloned to match the tags that are in your plant. For example, select Copy Current Record, input a new tag name, and then you can go in and customize the tag by going into the update. Let's modify this tag to match the tag that we're going to calibrate. Select calibration points, input the test tolerance, and input the number of test points that you want to test. Select calculate and auto design limits, and it'll automatically calculate the test points for this tag. To load a tag into the calibrator, select Upload Download. And here you can see the tags that are due or overdue by a certain date. To see all the tags, clear out that date and refresh the list. Here you can see the tags that are available to load into the calibrator. By selecting a tag, it's loaded into the Tags to Download box. This tag is now ready for download to the Fluke 754 calibrator. We've made the USB connection between the calibrator and the laptop. Now we're going to initiate the download of the procedure into the calibrator. Now we would perform the calibration of the tag that we've downloaded into the calibrator. Next, we're going to select the task loaded into the calibrator. The task is configured for a Type K thermocouple transmitter. Select More Choices and Task. Here you see the task that was loaded into the calibrator from the DPC Track 2 software. Press Enter to select the task, and then Continue to configure the calibrator for the test. Then select Auto Test to automatically document the performance of the transmitter. So here you see the recorded temperature values that were applied, milliamp values that were measured, and the errors percent of span. If the error percent of span is found greater than the test tolerance, it's flagged in reverse video. In this case, this indicates that this as found test of this transmitter has failed. Select Continue and confirm the tag ID. To enter the serial number, move to Serial Number and type in the serial number of the tag. Then Continue and Continue. Now that as found test is ready to upload to DPC Track 2 software. Next, we're going to upload the as found calibration result in the calibrator to DPC Track 2 software. Select Upload, confirm settings, then initiate upload from the calibrator to the software. Confirm upload settings. Once the results have been uploaded, you can review each record and authorize the record and record it into the database. Authorize. Upload complete. Let's look at results and print the results. To review calibration results, select Calibrations. All calibrations in the database are shown. Here's our tag. We can review the results. We can scroll forward through the records and find the different results that have been uploaded. To look at the test results, select Test Results. And here is the as found information of the tag we tested. To print this information in a report, select Reports. To preview, Calibration Preview. From here, you can review the report or select the print icon to print the report. We've gone full circle. We've created a tag in DPC Track 2 software, loaded into the Fluke 754 Documenting Process Calibrator, documented the results of the transmitter using a tag that was downloaded, uploaded the results back to DPC Track 2 software, reviewed the results, and printed a report.